Well, notice the bottom part of Wirecast 7's interface offers 5 distinct layers you can add media to. From top to bottom, these go foreground to background. As a general guideline, we recommend placing branding bugs, lower third titles, and other graphic overlays on the upper 2 layers, primary video sources on layer 3, chroma key backgrounds on layer 4, and audio on layer 5. You'll see as you select sources on their individual layers that they will appear in the preview window. Sources on higher layers will appear on top of any sources that have been selected on lower layers. A green light on the source's thumbnail indicates the source is selected in preview. If you would like to remove a source from showing in preview, you can click on the clear layer shot. Pressing Alt on PC or Option on Mac plus numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 will clear the number layer you enter as well. When you take a shot live by pressing the Go button arrow between the preview and live windows, you'll see the source thumbnail's green light turns into a red light to indicate that those sources are now selected live. You can now click on different sources to queue them up in the preview window without affecting your live output. Should you want to move a shot to a different layer, you can simply hover over the name of your shot until the cursor turns into a hand and drag your shot to the layer you would like it to appear on. If you need to adjust the size of shots appearing in any particular layer, you can click the up or down arrows on the right of whichever layer you'd like to modify. The up arrow will increase the size of the source thumbnails, and the down arrow will reduce them until all sources are hidden. You can also move your mouse between the monitor and the layers section of the interface until it turns into an up-down arrow icon. Then you can drag up or down to resize the interface to your needs. Layers can also be turned on or off completely by clicking the LED light at the right of a particular layer. Though there are 5 master layers, there can also be layers within shots. When you add a new source to a layer, you can double-click on that source thumbnail to open up the shot editor pane. Clicking the shot layers icon at the top left, which looks like a sandwich, will show you the selected source, and from there you can click on the plus button to add more sources. You can add as many sources to the shot as your hardware allows. The up and down arrows will move the source up or down in a layer, and the minus button will allow you to remove a source completely. Sources can also be marked as visible or invisible by selecting or deselecting the eye icon.